Hey, what's up? It's Mask Man Reviews back again with another video. Day 49 to 50. One more to go. We're gonna cross the finish line. We're almost there. The ribbon is laid out. We're just looking at that finish line, and we're pretty much just waiting to come across it so that we could raise our hands in victory. And it's not just me that is in victory. You're in victory as well, because you're watching with me and you've been on this journey with me. Like I said yesterday, I want to thank each and every one of you, especially you. Thank you. Today, what we have is From the House of Kilian by Kilian. And this one is Roses on Ice. Roses on Ice. And before I get into the notes, just to tell you about the fragrance and all that, I always kind of talk about the notes and stuff. The presentation is really gorgeous. It looks very similar to the Angel Share bottle, which I'll just kind of leave here in comparison. It's pretty much identical. The only difference is that the fragrance color is a nice opaque yellowish white instead of the dark amber color that Angel Share is. The perfumer on this one is Frank Volk, I believe, or Volke. And he is a perfumer that he has been in the business for a while, but I haven't really heard of him until today, to be quite honest with you. He's worked with many different houses, both niche and designer, and he's just been kind of pumping out pretty good work. And now I'm very curious to try some of his other fragrances just because of this particular one, which is Roses on Ice. Just such a beautiful scent. It draws you in, really does. The note combination on this one, at the top you have cucumber, juniper, and lime. At the heart you have rose, and then at the base you have amber, musk, and cedar. So it's a very simple note breakdown. What I'm getting from this fragrance, apart from what the notes say, is a very fresh, refreshing type scent. It's almost kind of, it opens up similar to like a gin and tonic. And I really like that scent profile. I'm not a big fan of drinking, so I'm not a big drinker, but I do like the way that that gin and tonic with the hint of lime, that smell is just so good, just so intoxicating. And that's what this smells like in the opening. You get that blast of like a gin and tonic, and it's so beautiful in the opening. It's just such a gorgeous scent. It'll enamor you, really will. The rose note does kind of come into play a little tiny bit, but this is not really a rosy scent, at least not on my skin. I did not detect much rose in this. So if you're detecting rose in this fragrance, I'm not sure. Maybe it's how it plays on your skin or your skin chemistry, but this, just such a gorgeous scent. That gin and tonic with the lime. Wow, that opening is just to die for. As this kind of settles down, this kind of has almost a second opening in the mid. And what I'm getting in that mid is a scent profile that is very similar to Silver Mountain Water. So that is what I'm getting. I'm getting a scent profile that is very similar to Silver Mountain Water when it kind of fully dries down in the mid. And you get that second opening per se. You get that about 2.5 hours into the fragrance. It just started to smell like Silver Mountain Water to me on my skin. And you know I like Silver Mountain Water, so it's a no-brainer for me. This is really a must-have at some point in time in my collection, although I have other fresh scents that kind of fit that profile. But to me, I'm sold. Anything that smells kind of like similar to that gin and tonic is just something that I really like in a fragrance. So for me, it's a must. But again, your miles may vary. I would say with such an expensive fragrance, you probably want to go ahead and try this out. But I'm loving this fragrance. It's supposed to be totally unisex, but to me, it actually leans a little bit more masculine on my skin. But Your miles may vary. I've heard that it's very rosy on some people. I've heard the rose note comes into play, but there's really not much sweetness about this fragrance. This is not a very sweet scent at all. If you do get some sweetness from it, it's really at the base that sweetness is going to come out, which is about 6 to 7 hours into the scent. You're going to get more of the sweetness. This is a very long lasting scent, something that lasted the entire day on me, probably 9+ hours. Projection wise, it's about 2 feet in the opening, so it has pretty good projection, and about 1.5 feet once it settles. And the good thing about this fragrance is that it's leaving kind of like a little bit of a scent bubble around me, so I'm able to get hints of the fragrance without having to dig my nose into my arm or anything like that. It's just something that you could smell as you're just kind of going about your day. One other fact about this is I had an appointment with one of my with actually the same dentist that gave me the compliment on the Giorgio Armani Absolute clone, and no compliments on this fragrance, so I did not get any compliments. But again, I'm not really sweating it. I really love that gin and tonic scent profile. That's really what it's all about right now for me. And I'm gonna look into other fragrances that have that scent profile, because it's just something that I really enjoy wearing. I don't necessarily like gin and tonic to drink all the time. I'm not a big drinker, like I said, but that scent profile, the way it wears on me, is just awesome. All right, people, like I said, 49, one more to go. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care of yourselves. Until the next one. Later.